Ita Buttrose's very serious jobs as the chair of the ABC and as patron of Dementia Australia, it's easy to forget that she has a sense of humour. But she does, and when she was a host on this little show, she'd often have us in stitches.
I like bad boys.
Yeah. I like cougars.
You'll be sent to me.
Go.
Well, sing it. Well, sing Matilda.
Right.
Okay, so.
Oh, gee, we had some fun, and Ita's found time in her very busy schedule to chat to us. Ita Buttrose, it's so lovely to see you. How are you?
Very well, but that's brought back a lot of nostalgia.
What in particular? Was it the shirtless man, perhaps?
It was just laughter, I think. It's just nice to remember all the laughter we enjoyed.
Oh, we had some fun, Ita.
Very serious world now.
Everything's great. Now, you are joining us today as patron of Dementia Australia,
yes,
and you're doing some wonderful work there. But before we get to that, love to get your thoughts on this. No one knows magazines and celebs like you do. And Meghan Markle, she's appeared in the latest interview for The Cut magazine. Some people have said that she's ruffled feathers, she's taken swipes. They've deduced from the interview. Do you think she's how do you think this interview's turned out for her?
Well, I think Meghan's provocative at the best of times, and you've got to remember she and Harry are forging their way in the world now as independent people. They don't have the royal family to fall back on. Mm-hmm. So they have to make every interview count. So because of all the other plans she's got, you know, the books, the movies, whatever, she wants to make sure she stands out in the crowd. So she makes provocative statements.
Do you think the pile-on is unfair?
The pile-on on Meghan or the pile-on from Meghan on the royal family?
Well, that's a good question, actually. Yeah. The press pile-on on Meghan Markle.
Well, Meghan's... I don't want to be unkind, but she's just a celebrity, and there's nothing wrong with being a celebrity, but she's one of many. Whereas once she was a princess of the realm, and she no longer has that role. So she goes on about her business of being a celebrity, and if she's enjoying it, good luck to her.
Mm. There we go. I've heard on the grapevine that you once dined with the Queen. How was that experience? Do you remember what you talked about?
I do. I had lunch with the Queen at Sydney Town Hall. And there were only four of us at the table. And the protocol is you don't discuss what you talk about with the Queen, so I tend to observe that. But I could tell you that she was very well informed about Australia. She loves Australia. And she's well informed about world affairs, which we discussed, but not in any detail, like not what the British government was planning, but just the state of the world at that time.
Very good. And someone who's very well informed is yourself, especially when it comes to Dementia Australia. They've just made accessing information easier by creating an audiobook version of their dementia guide with the help of a number of celebrities, including yourself. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, the idea is to make it easier for people with dementia and the people who care for people with dementia easier to find information because, you know, it's a shattering diagnosis and people often don't know much about dementia when they're diagnosed, and the carers don't know much, and the carers, who are so invaluable to the support of a person with dementia, are very stoic. And I've often said to a carer, have you had some counselling? Oh, no, I'm all right. But carers do need a bit of counselling. They do need a bit of support. So the audiobook is there for them to visit at whenever they want, and they can download individual chapters and look at something of interest to them. So it might be coping with the social isolation that often occurs when someone gets a diagnosis with dementia. And that is so common. And the carer suffers as well because people don't call, because not because they're uncaring, but simply because they don't quite know how to handle it.
Mm. It's such a cruel disease, dementia, and there's no cure, but we all live in hope of a medical breakthrough. There's been word of a vaccine against dementia, Ita. Do you know if they're far along with that?
Well, we wish. I can tell you, Sarah, there's so much work and research going on around the world and here in Australia even more so. And Professor Colin Masters down in Melbourne is working on a vaccine for Alzheimer's disease, but it's in its very early days yet, and it's probably not ready to be trialled on people. And of course, they have to be trialled on people. And we all live in hope that the breakthrough that we're so hoping for will come before long.
Most definitely. Unfortunately, we've all been involved in families where this is prevalent.
Yeah.
How important is an early diagnosis?
It's important with every condition, quite frankly, but it's important because the earlier you start, the little treatment there is, or the earlier you start to modify your lifestyle. For instance, we say there are risk reduction strategies. The earlier you follow these risk reduction strategies, like watching your blood pressure, watching your weight, watching your cholesterol, having some social activity, you know, it's so important that you keep connected with people. Doing some physical exercise, go for a walk, try and go for a walk every day. These things are very important and they do work and they do help alleviate the symptoms.
Also, people can find out more about the Dementia Guide. There's also a National Dementia Helpline, which is 24/7 now, which is really important, isn't it, Ita?
Yes, it is. And we're so thrilled that the 1-800 number is now 24/7, 1-800, 100, 500. So you can ring at any time because, you know, you never know when you think, oh, I need to talk to someone. I just need to talk to someone who's not going to judge me. Well, you can ring 1-800, 100, 500 and people will listen. They will not judge you and you will be helped by their advice, whether you're the person with the diagnosis or whether you're a family carer.
Well, that number again is 1-800 100 500 or you can head to dementia.org.au for the Dementia Guide and you'll also hear...
And that's where you can find the audiobook.
That's where you'll hear lovely Ida's voice. Yeah, fantastic, Ida.